Good afternoon, friends. My name is Death Metal Pixie, and welcome to my very first playthrough of Fallout 4. I'm not entirely sure why I chose Fallout 4 as my first playthrough, other than it's just a kick-ass game. Why the hell not? I decided to start a playthrough series, just period, for some of my friends out there that just would like to watch me play, so that's why I'm starting. We're going to start a brand new game. Just gonna jump right into it. My game is modded, and I'm sure we'll talk about the mods that I've used as we go through and as they're introduced. Nothing too major, mostly aesthetics, actually pretty much all aesthetics, minus like a armor mod, but I once again got that because I just thought it looked pimp. Anywho, we're going to go through the intro and everything like that for some of my friends who would like to see that. This is since we're pretty much going through the prologue, this first episode is pretty much, for those of you who've played the game, not a lot's going to go on. A lot of my commentary will be stifled by this, which I'll be quiet for a lot of it. Actually starting pretty soon, I'm going to shut the hell up. So here we go. Let's watch.
War. War never changes. In the year 1945, my great-great-grandfather, serving in the army, wondered when he'd get to go home to his wife and the son he'd never seen. He got his wish when the U.S. ended World War II by dropping atomic bombs on Hiroshima and Nagasaki. The world awaited Armageddon. Instead, something miraculous happened. We began to use atomic energy not as a weapon, but as a nearly limitless source of power. People enjoyed luxuries once thought the realm of science fiction. Domestic robots, fusion-powered cars, portable computers. But then, in the 21st century, people awoke from the American dream. Years of consumption led to shortages of every major resource. The entire world unraveled. Peace became a distant memory. It is now the year 2077. We stand on the brink of total war. And I am afraid. For myself. For my wife. For my infant son. Because if my time in the army taught me one thing, it's that war never changes. Changes.
You're gonna knock him dead at the veterans hall tonight, hon.
You think?
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Now get ready and stop hogging the mirror.
Right.
So here's our character creation screen. We can toggle between.
My turn, yep. Big guy.
Hey. We can toggle between sexes doing that. In case you couldn't tell, it's a married couple that you can choose, so either you're going to be a female main character with a husband or a male main character with a wife. I'm going to stick with a female character. I just prefer to. No other reason than that. Now, the preset here, I'm probably going to work off of her. She's pretty good, other than I'm going to make a few changes. Nothing tremendously drastic, but there. We can already see a couple of mods going on here. Mostly it's things like just improving the texture of the skin, What I like about the mods that I picked for the face, though, and the eyes in particular that I'm looking at right now, is that they're all choosable. If you don't want to have a super, you know, perfect looking face, you don't have to have it. But in this case, I just felt like making a very pretty lady, so I went ahead and did that. If you disagree with my choice in pretty, you can go somewhere else. I don't know. I think she looks really nice. So that's what we got. They're coming on out. It's kind of superfluous, but I am gonna work a little bit on.
Let me just slide in here.
Yeah, I'm gonna work a little bit on the husband as well. I'm gonna take care of that really quickly as well. Let's see here.
What do you think, hon? Roguishly handsome or handsomely roguish?
And there's my teddy bear. I don't know. I like the way he looks. Good enough for me. Well, what do you see, sweet pea? Where'd you get it? Sorry, I have a cat around my legs who happened to see a butterfly or a moth. Have at it, go get it. Kill it. Okay. Good, good. So we're gonna go back. Let's see what else we got. Sorry. Do do do. Oh, a lip cut. Sure. It's fine. We'll go ahead and leave the stuff on him. Like I said, he's gonna be the he's just my husband. Just my husband.
Sir? Okay, come on.
It looks so serious. Get the fuck out. Thank you. I'm not done. My eyeshadow smudge at the bottom. Gotta fix it. Alright, so now we're ready to start the game. We have a husband. We have me. Let's get this going. That's how that works. And now we begin. As I said before, I'm going to be a little quiet during the beginning here because I don't want to fill too much of the space up with commentary that's just going to end up being trite. There's just not a lot of commentary to say initially because the prologue will speak for itself. Oh, hello, buddy. Oh, you got daddy's tan. This is our baby. Hello, my little boy. I hope in future episodes that.
Good morning, Mommy. Your coffee. 173.5 degrees Fahrenheit.
Perfect.
To perfection. And today's newspaper just delivered.
Codsworth, he's pretty cool. Let's have a sip there. Thank you. Mwah. I should technically be able to see myself right now. Actually, I just noticed that. That's kind of fucked up. I don't have a reflection. Huh. Bethesda, get on that.
Grognak the Barbarian and the Jungle of the Bat Babies.
Quality. A little bit of
sugar bombs. 100% daily value like of sugar.
Made a sticky. I shall attend to young Shaw.
I know we were nervous at first, but I'm glad we got Codsworth.
Me too. He changes our baby's diapers for us. Yes, no more shit to deal with. No more poo-poos.
Nuka-Cola. Ice cold. Saddle up Salisbury steak. Rated A+.
Mm-mm-mm. You guys remember Salisbury steak day at school? Yeah. I hated those
days. Looks like the milk got delivered.
Wasn't a fan.
All the easier for a mechanized Hellcat to drive any screaming commie meme.
That salesman again. I don't know why he keeps bothering you.
Screaming commie memes.
A lot of late nights. But it was worth it.
A little bit of background. I am a law degree student.
Good old US of A.
And my husband is ex-military.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Vault-Tec calling.
Will be nice. This playthrough will be of a nice character for the most part.
Good morning.
Isn't it? Just look at that sky out there. You can't begin to know how happy I am to finally speak with you. I've been trying for days. It's a matter of utmost urgency, I assure you.
Well, glad you're here.
Then I'm glad I opened the door.
Oh, me too. You have no idea.
Sarcasm.
Now I know you're a busy woman.
Are we related?
So I won't take up much of your time. time being, a precious...
That was so not intentional. I did not mean to.
I'm here today to tell you that because of your family service to our country, you have been pre-selected for entrance into the local vault. Vault 111.
Yeah, the red hair and green eyes, that didn't mean to do that. But, I have a family.
But I have a family. You can fit us all, right?
Of course, of course. Minus your robot, naturally.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, you're already cleared for entrance. It's just a matter of verifying some information. Don't want there to be any holdups in the unforeseen event of total atomic annihilation. Won't take but a moment.
Tell me more.
Tell me more about this vault.
Oh, it has all the amenities of a modern home, I assure you. Not to mention total protection from nuclear radiation and hostile mutants.
That don't exist
a
yet, but whatever.
A better future underground. It's not only our mission, it's our passion.
I love that. They mentioned hostile mutants, but we haven't... Like... They don't know what mutants are. Whatever. Let's do it!
Sure. Let's do it.
Splendid! Splendid. Now, let's see.
So here's where we get to select our character's name and what we do really well, effectively, where our strengths lie, effectively. I do love the special spelling, by the way, that tickled me at Fallout 3. So we're going to name our character Wyatt. I kind of decided that from the very beginning. And I'm going to make sure, yeah, that's, I want to spell it the way that it's recognized by Codsworth, because that's pretty cool to hear your own name in the game. So let's see what we've got here. So we have our 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, how do you say, personal scores, I suppose, your strengths, effectively, that help you out in the wasteland that we'll inevitably be facing. This will take some consideration here. Let me think about it. Perfect! Let's get this ball rolling. Like those stats. Let's do this. Except.
Wonderful. That's everything. Just gonna walk this over to the vault. Congratulations on being prepared for the future.
Bye.
Thanks again.
Hey, it's peace of mind. That's worth a little paperwork, right?
For you and Sean, no price is too high.
Good answer.
I have my moments.
Ooh, that was delayed.
Miss Wyatt?
Oh, yeah.
Sean has been changed, but he absolutely refuses to calm down. I think he needs some of that maternal affection you seem to be so good at.
Go ahead, honey. I'll be there in a second to help, okay?
All right. Come here.
My boy isn't giving his mother any trouble, is he? Hey, I fixed that mobile on his crib the other day. Why don't you give it a spin?
Sure. Alright. You like that?
That's my boy. On his best behavior, just like his dad. Well, most of the time.
Oh, I gave you some cheekies.
Listen, after breakfast, I was thinking we could head to the park for a bit. Weather should hold up.
But what about Halloween, bro?
Let's get pumpkins instead. Carve jack-o'-lanterns.
Sir?
Let's do what I want.
You should come and see this.
Codsworth? What's wrong?
Followed by... Yes, followed by flashes, blinding flashes. Sounds of explosions.
Uh-oh.
We're, trying to get confirmation. We seem to have lost contact with our affiliate stations.
Oh, no.
We do have coming in. That's, confirmed reports, I repeat, confirmed reports of nuclear detonations in New York and Pennsylvania. My God.
Uh-oh.
We need to get to the vault.
Now!
I've got
Residents of
Sanctuary. Now we're on the run.
If you are registered, evacuate to Vault 111.
At this point, we're pretty much just gonna follow these guys. I'm actually really happy for them. The first time I played this, I didn't know where to go. And these helpful people.
Just help me pack it up.
Fuck the suitcase, just go! Yeah, exactly.
After the game, all participants check in there. That's absurd. I am
not on the list. You don't get
in. I'm going in. You can't stop me. Okay. I'm reporting this.
Not in the vault. If you're in the program, step forward. Otherwise, return home.
We need to get in. We're on the list.
Yeah.
Infant? Adult male? Adult female? Okay, go ahead.
Thank you.
Good luck,
you
sir.
You two, follow me.
God,
come on.
What's going to happen to all those people outside
We're
the gate?
We're doing everything we can. Now keep moving.
The running animation's a little goofy as we're watching this guy do his little jog.
Step on the platform. In the center.
That's okay.
Is Sean okay?
He's fine. We're gonna be okay. I love you.
Oh my God!
Okay.
Hold on!
In an orderly fashion.
No need to worry, folks. We'll get everyone situated in your new home. Vault 111. A better future underground.
So we just...
Yes, up the stairs.
I can't believe it. If we left a minute later...
No.
We'd all be.
Don't get caught up thinking about that. You're safe now. Everyone, just head up these stairs and through the door there.
Here for you.
Oh yeah.
All new residents, please proceed in an orderly fashion.
Female.
Welcome home.
Hey.
This one's good.
This way, please. Step over to the table. Just this way.
Okay. Female.
Yeah, the
pick up a suit right over there.
Thanks, bro.
Just step over to the table.
There's so many voices and so much text. It's hard to keep track of exactly what's going on. I mean, it's ultimately not tremendously important, but...
You'll need your suits before we can take you further.
There are things you kind of pick up on every time you replay that you didn't notice before.
What now? Just follow the doctor here. He'll show you where to go.
Thank you.
All right, you three. Follow me.
Yes, sir.
See? This is our new home.
Come on, baby. Come on, boy.
Oh, you're gonna love it here. This is one of our most advanced facilities. Not that the
Take
others aren't great, mind you.
It's gone. Our home. Everything we had.
My mother and father down in D.C.
Ma'am?
Oh, God, honey.
The hell's on his shoulder? Whoa.
I know
whoa.
This is a difficult time. But
the hell is that? That's one hell of a birthmark you got there. Way,
you'll thrive.
Shit.
Did you have any
Sorry.
How long do you think we'll be down here?
Oh, we'll be going over all that in orientation. Just a few medical items we have to get through first.
Sorry if I'm whipping around a lot. I'm
checking everyone off the list as they come in.
Not looking at your ass.
For the future, right?
Such a lovely family you have. I hope you'll see this as your new home.
But I like to take
in
as much as I can.
And put your vault suit on.
It'll be okay. Mommy's right here. See? Honey?
Who is my little guy, huh? I'm not going far. I'll just be over there.
Is he okay? He looks kind of dead.
There she is, see?
Hey.
Mommy's not going far.
All
tickle,
set?
Tickle,
just step inside and put on your vault suit.
Don't rush me, motherfucker. My baby needs my maternal affection. Can't you tell? Oh, he's got your tan. Oh. Okay, let's go. Got it on. Look at those sweet ass nails. So
the pod will decontaminate and depressurize you before we head deeper in the fall. Just relax.
Sure.
For a whole new life.
Resident secure.
Hey, baby. Can't see it, but I'm totally putting my hand up there too.
Normal. Procedure complete.
So
in 5.
I can't move anymore.
4,
well, we have a 3, few seconds. So some of the mods, like I said, that you've seen, they've all been aesthetic. I have a couple of, I have a face smoothing mod. I have a mod for certain facial textures, or in this case, like bigger eyes that I gave my character. And in case you kind of noticed about my husband, he's got some major eyelashes going on. I have, what was it called? It's not the Eyes of Beauty, but, there's another eye mod I have that gives some major eyelashes, and I like it personally. Even for the males, it kind of gives them a little bit more animation, and I like that. Oh.
Open it.
Let's fucking beat against the glass. Wait, let me out too. That's my husband and baby you got there. Motherfucker.
Hold on. Everything's gonna be fine.
I got it.
Let the boy go. I'm only gonna tell you once.
I'm not giving you shot.
Fuck. Yeah, that just happened.
Please, we still have the backup.
Get the fuck out of my fur. Yeah, that guy. That guy. I have your fucking number, douchebag. Yeah, I won't forget you. So yeah, in case you also noticed my bitchin' nails, I also have, was it Caliente's Beautiful Body Package? Beautiful Body Enhancement, CBBE. If you don't have it, you should look into getting it. Totally worth it. Look at that. Gorgeous manicure. I like it anyway. Okay, here we go.
Come on. There has to be a release.
Here we go, here we go.
Come on, come on, come on. Oh, God. I'll find who did this. And I'll get Sean back. I promise.
Yeah. I can hear a shiver and it makes me shiver, actually.
Oh, God. Why would Baltic do this?
So, that's me. Yeah, everyone is dead. Just
I can't be the only one left. Hello? Anyone?
Everyone's dead. There's no point in checking every single pod. I'm the only one left alive. We can even take a look at the monitor here. Premature termination resulting in system failure. Isolated manual and remote overrides detected. Controls disabled. We can look at life support. It's offline. Duh, everyone's dead. Dead. Deceased. Life support, blah, 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 blah. I was opened, and you're dead. And, yeah. There's really no point in looking at all that. And since the other room, it's just really a lot more dead people.
Ugh. They're dead.
And the monitor that will explain the same thing that we already know. It is pretty gruesome, though, to note that everybody that we entered the vault with is dead. Every single person. They all died of asphyxiation because life support fucking... You're right. You got it. You got it. Pat on the back. You're gonna be all right. We can't. Yep. Stop shivering. Make me shiver by proxy. Oh yeah. Bye. Blech. Giant cockroaches. Oh, stand pat. Let's take a look at a little bit of the terminal here for anybody interested enough. So confidential, they had to say it three times. Vault 111 is designed to test the long-term effects of suspended animation on unaware human subjects. Security staff are responsible for maintaining installation integrity and monitoring science staff activity. Under no circumstances are staff allowed to deviate from assigned duties. Insubordination or interference with vault operations are capital offenses. Security staff are authorized to use lethal force. Yeah. Upon activation notice from Vault Tech, all personnel are required to report to the entry area and assist with admittance of Vault residents. Security personnel will maintain order and ensure that no personnel or residents attempt to evacuate the vault. Research staff will be responsible for resident intake and escort each to the designated cryogenic pod. Residents not accounted for in the manifest should be asked to step aside and detained forcefully by security if necessary. Once all residents have been sealed onto their preservation chambers, dispose of any detainees. I repeat, kill anyone who wasn't supposed to be there. Vault entryway must remain sealed under any circumstances. Good fucking god. I forgot about this. Science that. Let's breeze through this. Members of the research team must daily monitor the vital signs of cryogenically preserved residents. Cardiopulmonary and cognitive activity in particular must be recorded hourly. Ugh, sounds like my current job. Ugh. Life-saving intervention is only permitted if greater than 80% of the resident population has perished while in cryogenic suspension and must not interrupt suspension. Independent research is encouraged and left to overseer discretion. Security patrols are to be carried out on a constant 8-hour rotation. Security priorities include monitoring for signs of intrusion, checking for atmosphere leaks, settling disputes among personnel, enforcement of regulations set forth by the overseer, enforcement of regulations set forth by Vault Tech, blah, 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 blah. Due to the nature of Vault Tech 111, personnel will be expected to perform duties outside of their normal qualifications, such as janitorial duties and food preparation. The exact distribution of these roles is left to overseer discretion. Yeah. One guy. The all clear message. Following a nuclear event, Vault Tech will monitor hazards such as radiation levels, enemy invasion, subsequent attacks, and other factors. Once conditions are deemed safe, the terminal will receive an all-clear notice. Upon receiving the all-clear notice, Vault Tech personnel may be evacuated at overseer discretion. Disregard any notices from organizations or individuals not associated with Vault Tech, including government and military. Residents are not to be disrupted or evacuated. Vault Tech will attend to their needs remotely once Vault 111 staff has been evacuated. And finally, mandatory blah 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 blah. Vault 111 is classified as a short-term assignment. Non-resident personnel are expected to carry out research duties and basic maintenance of the vault while awaiting the all-clear signal to evacuate. In the absence of an all-clear message from Vault Tech, the overseer may elect to evacuate staff after a mandatory shelter period of 180 days of containment. Under no circumstances may Vault 111 staff evacuate during this shelter period unless receiving the all-clear message. Blah, 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 blah. So, in case some of you didn't get that, we... Vault Tech are dicks. Let's just get that out of the way. And basically, we were all kept here and cryogenically frozen under false pretenses. That being the cryogenically frozen part. Yeah. It's pretty shitty. Let's kill some rad roaches to vent some steam. And he's gonna turn around. I like my sneak attacks. Here we go. Oh, I'm gonna power attack you so fucking hard. Oh my god, it's gonna be so good. Oh my god. Ah! Okay.
Giant roaches.
What the hell? Pardon me, guys. I'm taking a drink or nine in this case. So we're safe. Put that away. Stuff that right in my pants. Loot. Just doing a bit of a sweep. Nope. Nothing. Okay, there's no reason to be in here. Nothing. I'll take that cup. No! Stop! Oh my god. This is not the time. Get the fuck up. That bottle's empty anyway. Oh my god. Thank you. Dead ass. Okay. You can tell it's been a minute or two since I've, been here. In case you're wondering why I'm picking up every rusted hot plate and super old coffee cup, we can use this stuff for later, and I kind of like having ceramic and glass in my inventory. Let me see your memo. Remember, the use of the recreational terminal is a privilege. If work performance declines, this privilege may be revoked. Enjoy responsibly. Oh, stop. So this is really cool. This is where you get to see how holotapes work, how I have the option to eject one right now or to play it. Let's go ahead and play it for a minute. Just really quick. Let's just one time through. 10 points to anyone who can tell me what this is based on. It's pretty much a game, so... Hello, little penis head. That nostalgia, though. Here we go. Let's go. No deaths! Zero deaths! Let's go! Oh, fuck. Jump! No! Oh, that's embarrassing. Oh, the ego. Oh, how it is bruised. That didn't happen. We're just gonna say that didn't happen. Fuck you, fuck your boulders. Yes, fuck you. Oh my god, I don't know how. Oh my god, I thought I was done for. Gimme. Okay. No deaths! Okay, one. How high can you get? Really fucking high. Oh, I didn't mean to do that. Oh my god! Give. Go. Bullshit! That was bullshit. I can still do this. I can still make this happen. I can still do this. We can make it. There's only three levels. We can do this. What are you gonna do? I don't trust you. Fuck you. Okay, we got this. Okay, come on, you can do this. Go. Okay, does this change? I don't know. Oh my god, don't. Good. We just need to get up there. Yes! I don't know why I take this so personally. Actually, I do kinda. I hate losing. I like winning. I don't know what to say. So we're just gonna knock all the dildos down. Yeah, fuck you. Get lost. We can do it. Oh, we have one more. We can do it. Oh, we got this. We win. Woo! All right. Okay, and then it just kind of starts from the beginning. We got the message. Quick game. Cool. Okay, I'm gonna take that with me. Okay, that's enough. That's enough of that. Okay, let's go. Thank you, guys. Yeah. Now we got some heroic cockroach slaying to do. Let's see if we can get this guy. Yep. Take that meat. We're gonna need it for later. Oh, yeah, I knew you were here. bring it. Come on, come on over. Come on. Come on over. Oh, oh. He's fucking up that skeleton. Okay, he's gonna... Okay, I guess she won't say anything while the cockroach is there. Come on. Oh. I wish I could get him from here. Nope. It was worth a try. Where is he? How did that not kill you? I ask you. Come on. Fuck. Hey, that was your fault.
What happened here? Where is everyone?
Kinda wanna know. You know what? No, there. That's only an idiot would go out there. Let's do this. Bring it, bring it. Gotcha. You know, I don't need any more rad roach meat. Ah! I was not just startled by a rad roach. Let me just tell you right there. Let me get a sip of water, because I'm thirsty. I'm not scared. You know what? Fuck you guys. Whatever. Oh, we got a pistol. Good. 10mm round.
Is this all that's left?
Yeah, man. I hate to break it to you, but everyone's pretty much dust and bones. I'm sorry. But that's okay. I do also apologize for, like I said, spinning around, kind of zipping through, but really, if there was something that I felt was important, I would have kind of stopped on it. Like, nice. This, for example.
Coming back later for you.
I came back for you. I need a master lock, which I just don't have. I'm level one. We have to unlock the terminal here to get through there. We just read that. Okay, we are the Overseer now, I think. So, I have long dreamed of making cryogenic freezing available in a portable, on-demand form. The cryolator is my latest attempt. Thankfully, we're in no short supply of the chemicals and components I need to tinker with the prototype. It's a nice way to occupy the time as we wait for the all-clear signal. Weirdo. Residence admittance. Upon activation notice, all personnel required report. We've seen this too. We've seen all of this. We don't. Sorry. Nope! There we go. Overseer's log. The final staff orientation is complete. All but a few of the residents down in Sanctuary Hills have been enrolled, and several from Concord as well. Vault Tech supervisors came up this week to do a technical review with me. This vault is ready to open. I can only imagine what wonders our residents will get to witness. The notion of leaping forward in time. I almost wish I could join them and see the promise of our future realized. It's happened. We were lucky that most of the staff was nearby when the early warning came through. We had less notice than expected, but only Nordhagen was missing when we sealed the entrance. Residence admittance went smoothly. Everyone made it, even the family that waited until the last minute. I was worried there would be more suspicion, but things happened so fast for these people. They must have been too overwhelmed to question the cryogenic pods. Well, when you tell us they aren't cryogenic... Strange issue today with pod C3. Subject appeared to be having heart palpitations. Nothing life-threatening, but unusual. We realized almost too late that the pod was malfunctioning. The cryogenic array almost started thawing her out. We're not sure, but I suspect a hiccup in Vault Tech's remote override systems may have sent an errant signal. We'll have to keep an eye out. I only hope their systems are reliable once we evacuate the staff. Shit's going down. There's been no all-clear signal yet, and even though we're nearing the end of the 180-day mandatory shelter period, supplies were never intended to last much longer than that, and despite my best efforts, people are beginning to question what we're doing down here. If people think we can just leave when the 180 days are up, they're insane. The radioactive exposure would still be potent enough to fry everyone if the vault seals are breached that early. The whole point of the all clear was to receive additional instructions from the main office. I don't know what to do. I can't open the vault. I can't expect our supplies to last forever. I just have to keep everything under control until the all clear. A faction led by the security personnel have turned on me, demanding that they be allowed to leave the vault. Idiots. I will not open the door to be irradiated to death out there. I'm consolidating the remaining supplies, putting the staff on lockdown. We're going to have to start prioritizing who deserves what little food we have left. I've been too damn generous with the rations. If people don't like it, well, that's fewer mouths to feed. God damn it. I'd like to get out, Kay, thanks. So, thank you. Okay, we opened it. I think there is one other terminal that I didn't see or look at, but I... Fuck. Ah! I swear, I'm good. Ah! I didn't even see you. Fuck. Give me all your meat. Oh, I forgot about this part. There's still more. Oh my god, there's still more. There have to be. Oh, stupid. Oh, let's reload. Hang on. Yeah, cock that shit. Ugh, pissed. I don't know. I hate it when things don't go my way. But yeah, the other terminal's not tremendously important. It's pretty much just corroborating the whole mutiny thing. Fuck you. What was that? Oh.
Is anyone alive? Did anyone get out?
Sad to say, no. I do not think anyone got out. Man, it's just not my day today.
Am I the only one left?
Yes. Yes, you are. I'm sorry. I do like the little bits of immersion there with the Pip-Boy. The way that it looks, the way that you can kind of... It looks like something that could actually exist, and I like that. You can't see it, but I'm totally thumbs-upping you back, little man. Okay. And this is just the Pip-Boy. Those of you who don't know what it is, you'll get well acquainted with it as we play the game, because this is what I used to play the game to get around. So I'm not even gonna bother explaining it. You'll figure it out real quick. Let's do this. Let's get the fuck out of here. That, put that right back in, and pop!
Vault door cycling sequence initiated. Please, stand back.
Prepare for epicness. So good. I don't know why. Everything's gonna rust into shit now. Oh, I'm so excited to start this with you guys. The game is actually going to begin soon. An actual commentary can commence. Probably not until the second episode. I'm not gonna play too much longer today after this. Let's go. Let's get this game going.
Enjoy your return to
Okay. Squealing's over, I promise. I'm ready. Just the prologue's fun, but when you're trying to record yourself, you start to get antsy because you have things you want to say, but you don't want to interrupt anything, and now that's kind of over. So, yeah, now shit can begin.
That makes me happy.
Oh, for some reason that really hurts my eyes. I'm right along with you, Wyatt. Oh, God. Ugh. Ugh. Shock sigh indeed. There's home. Sadly, we're not gonna take in too much of this. I'm really in loot mode at the moment. Some of you might be able to tell, the landscape looks a little bit greener than normal. Yeah, I did install a mod that adds a bit more greenery to the landscape. I'm supposed to be seeing leaves. I think I might have actually flubbed and forgot to completely install a mod that adds a little bit of foliage to the trees as well. I'll work on that for next time, but yeah, I don't know. I wanted to see more grass in my Fallout game. Especially since after 200 years, a lot of people are pretty certain that greenery would start to come back to the planet, and I'm all with that. Plus, just when you see a lot of brown, you get sick of it, so green it is. Yeah, bug you. Green. Where are those silt beans? There they are. Let's go. So we're gonna head back to Sanctuary really quick to, well, see what happened to our home. Oh yeah, let's... Oh yeah, admire that unrealistically crystal clear water. Another mod I installed because I liked it. I don't understand the little twangy guitar music here. It kind of makes me think of the Old West. And we are pretty far east, so I don't really get that.
As I live and breathe.
Codsworth!
Oh, it's really
yeah, man. Dude, what the fuck happened?
Codsworth, what happened to the world?
The world, Mum? Well, besides our geraniums still being the envy of Sanctuary Hills, I'm afraid things have been dreadfully dull around here. Things will be so much more exciting with you and Sir back. Where is your better half, by the by?
Taste that denial. Yeah, I'm pissed. I'm just gonna say it straight.
They killed him.
Oh, Mum, these things you're saying, these terrible things, I believe you need a distraction. Yes, a distraction to calm this dire mood. It's been ages since we've had a proper family activity. Checkers, or perhaps charades. Oh, Sean does so love that game. Is the lad with you?
No. Do you see him with me? No. They stole him.
He's gone. God damn it. Someone took him. They stole my baby.
I'm pissed.
It's worse than I thought. You're suffering from hunger-induced paranoia. Not eating properly for 200 years will do that, I'm afraid.
200 years?
What?
Are you
sure?
A bit over 210, actually, Mum. Give or take a little of the Earth's rotation and some minor dings to the old chronometer. That means you're 2 centuries late for dinner. Perhaps I can whip you up a snack. Must be famished.
Codsworth, you're acting a little weird. What's wrong?
Let's talk about this.
Mom, it's been just horrible.
No.
2 centuries with no one to talk to, no one to serve. I spent the first 10 years trying to keep the floor.
Camera, don't correct me.
Nothing gets out nuclear fallout from
vinyl wood. Nothing.
And don't get me started about the futility of dusting a collapsed house. And the car. The car. How do you polish rust?
You don't. The car. Okay, dude. Stay with me.
Stay with me, pal. Focus.
Stay with me.
I'm afraid I don't know anything, Mom. The bombs came and all of you left in such a hurry. I thought for certain you and your family were dead. I did find this holotape. I believe Sir was going to present it to you as a surprise. But then, well, everything happened.
A holotape? What's on it?
I believe it's a private message for you. My etiquette protocols would not permit me to play it for myself.
Of course not.
Any standard holotape reading device should be able to play it back. Oh, like that Pip-Boy on your arm. That should work brilliantly.
Where did you find that, by the by?
I'm feeling sorry for myself.
Never mind.
Shall we search the neighborhood together? Sir and young Sean may turn up yet.
Let's do it. Well, let me ask you really quick. I've never asked before. What, anything dangerous?
Have you seen anything dangerous?
Oh, just the usual, Mum. Pesky neighborhood dogs and mosquitoes.
Mosquitoes? Let's do it.
All right. Lead the way.
Proud to serve, Mum.
Let's go, Wyatt. No. We want this. Not without me. I want to kill things too. Ugh, God, I suck. I swear to God, I did so much better last time. Go. Where is their body? Give me your glands. Wow, that music's obnoxious. Maybe I needed to turn that down. I don't know how it is for you guys, but right just then I could barely hear Codsworth. Granted, it didn't help that I was kind of whipping around. I was whipping around like a fucking idiot, but I see you. Yes! I'm awesome. That's how I roll. Let's do this. Where are you? Just the other- Ah! Okay. I knew it was gonna be there. I don't even know why I shrieked like that.
Miss Wyatt, your family isn't here either. Oh. They're really gone, aren't they?
Yeah, they're gone, dude. I'm sorry. It's okay, though.
Thanks for trying, Codsworth.
Whoa.
Can't give up, Mum. What about the city? Concord is nearby, and, well, the people there have only shot at me a few times.
Concord?
There's still people alive in Concord?
Yes, although they're a bit rough. You remember the way? Just across the southern footbridge, out of the neighborhood, and past the Red Rocket Station?
I shall remain here and secure the home.
Yes, ma'am. I'll stay here. You wander the terrible wasteland all on your own. Yes, I might have a good foot-long buzzsaw, flamethrower, and a few rockets, but no, ma'am, I can't be bothered to come and help you. Although...
There must be someone who can help you.
Oh, yeah. But not me. No. I must stay here and trim the overgrown bushes and wipe out the few bloatflies. You go to Concord on your own, Mum. Have fun with that. Enjoy that. Thanks. So, Concord is up next. However, I think that will keep until the next episode. This one's going to be really long already, I can tell. I'll probably edit it down to a more manageable length, but I can tell it's going to be a little ridiculous. So I'll end here. Next time, we'll head to Concord. Thank you all so much for watching. And if you enjoyed the video, please leave a like and feel free to subscribe if you want to see more. It'll at least let me know that what I'm doing is interesting, if nothing else. If you have any critiques to give, any suggestions for making the video interesting to you, please let me know. Please feel free to leave a comment and tell me. I love constructive criticism. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you all next time. Bye!